Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to continue with our 6th chapter and our topic for today is Mahmud Ghazni. So, in this chapter we had already studied about the administration, literature and architecture during the Rajput age. Though the Rajput age is well known for its valor and sacrifice, it also saw the construction of many beautiful imposing buildings. Many foreign invaders invaded India during this period. Mahmud Ghazni, the Sultan of Ghazna, attacked India many times between 1000 CE and 1075 CE. In spite of facing problems during attacks, he continued to plunder India with full force. During one such attack, when Gujarat was under Bhimdev Solanki's rule, he plundered Somnath. Many people from Saurashtra and Gujarat joined Bhimdev Solanki and tried to protect Somnath but failed. So, as the Rajput the architecture of Rajput was so unique and so beautiful that all the foreign people had their eyes on the architecture of India. So this Mahmud Ghazni, he was the king of Ghazna and he was the sultan from there, and he attacked India so many times between 1000 CE and 1075 CE. After that, in spite of facing problems, in spite of having such large attacks like he was doing on India, but he was facing so many problems while attacking the India, but he still continued. He did not give up, and still he continued to attack. After that, he continued to plunder India with full force, and then he started attacking India with full force. And during one such attack, during one of those attacks, when Gujarat was under Bhimdev Solanki's rule, the king of Gujarat during that time was Bhimdev Solanki, and he plundered Somnath. He robbed Somnath, he attacked Somnath. Many people from Saurashtra and Gujarat joined Bhimdev Solanki and tried to protect Somnath but failed. So there were many people who were trying to control or who were trying to fight with Sultan of Ghazna, but no, all the people from Gujarat got together, they got united and tried to stop that attack and win that battle, but Solankis were not able to succeed, and they were not succeeded in protecting the Somnath temple. So this was about the Mahmud Ghazni. Here is the map, you can see the map of route of Mahmud Ghazni. From where did he came to India? See here, from this but he came to Ajmer, from Ajmer Anhil, and from there he came to Veerabal, which is in Somnath, where the Somnath is. So this was the route of Somnath's invasion. He took this route to come to the Somnath temple. So you can see this map very clearly over here. And now moving forward to the next topic, which is change of power at Delhi. After the demise of Mahmud Ghazni, the leader of Ghazna started waving for the throne. However, the Rajput king did not take advantage of this weakness. Meanwhile, Shahabuddin Ghori established his strong rule in Ghazna and decided to attack India. His intention was not to loot but establish his rule over here. So, after the demise, after the Mahmud Ghazni died, there were other leaders who were there on the throne, and however, the Rajput kings did not take advantage of this weakness. Although all the kings like the after Mahmud Ghazni, the leaders of Ghazna were not that strong, but the Rajputs did not took any advantage of their weakness. But meanwhile, Shahabuddin Ghori established his strong rule in Ghazna and decided to attack India. But Shahabuddin Ghori, he thought that he would first rule on Ghazna and then from there he would attack India. His intention was not to loot. His intention was not to take away the things from India and take it at his Ghazna. But his intention was to rule on India. He wanted to rule over India. Initially, he wasn't successful. He could not forget his defeat by Queen Naika Devi of Anilwad Patan and therefore did not attack India for 12 years. Finally, the second time he attacked Delhi. So during initially he became the king and he started to attack and he wanted to rule the India, at that time he was not successful. So he continuously tried to attack, but he did not succeed in that thing. So what he did, then he one fight was happened with the Queen Naika Devi, and she was the queen of Anilwad Patan. That defeat, he defeated so badly. He was defeated so badly by the Queen Naika Devi of Anilwad Patan that for some years he completely stopped the attacks on all parts of India. Like, he did not dare to attack any parts of India. So after some years, like after 12 years, finally the second time he attacked Delhi, and then after a few times and after some years, few years, he attacked Delhi. Prithviraj fought bravely but without any prior preparation or help from the other Rajput king. So during that time when he attacked the Shahabuddin Ghori, when he attacked on Delhi, at that time Prithviraj was the king of that Delhi, and he was not aware or he was not knowing about this attack which Shahabuddin Ghori was going to do. So he, without any prior preparation, without taking any help from the other Rajput kings, he fought so nicely. Then with his defeat, the Rajput rule came to an end in Delhi, but they were not successful. Prithviraj could not defeat the Shahabuddin Ghori, and after that the rule of Rajput came to end, and as a result Shahabuddin established his rule there and extended his kingdom. And what happened after going there and after ruling over the Delhi, he started extending his kingdom. He started fighting with the nearby areas and he extended his kingdom. After Shahabuddin, his slave, who was also his commander, whose name was Qutbuddin Aibak, ascended the throne. And after Shahabuddin, Qutbuddin Aibak, he came to the throne, and he was known as the founder of slave dynasty. And with this, Rajput rule came to an end in Delhi. There was a change in administration and society. What kind of changes took place and why? Think about the questions like this. In place of valor and sacrifice, people started conspiring against each other for power. The throne of Delhi was stained with blood. So after the Rajput age, this is how the Rajput age came to an end, and the place where the Rajputs used to sacrifice their life and they used to fight for their kingdom and for their people, and that place was fully stained with blood because everyone was fighting with each other for ruling over that place. So this is how the Rajput rule came to an end. And our chapter gets completed over here. We'll continue the next chapter in the next class. Thank you.